Johnny Otis, 1958. Johnny Otis is a legendary figure in popular music, one of the unsung fathers of rock and roll. Back in the 40s, Otis and a few other musicians took Count Basie's big band sound, fused it to Southern black blues, and came up with rhythm and blues, the foundation of rock and roll. For Otis, it reached its high point in 1958 with his biggest hit, Willie and the Hand Jive. And 25 years later, at age 61, Johnny Otis still sets them dancing. He's now joined by his sons, Shuggy on guitar, Nicky on drums, pounding out a beat he first heard from Count Otis Matthews in the late 30s.
They all dig that crazy beat.
Count Matthews would bring tin cans taped with little pebbles or something inside of them, set them on the piano, and the highlight of the evening would be when he would look out and find the prettiest girls he could find and call them up and give them these cans and tell them to just shake them. And they'd go, shing, 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 shing. And he'd tell me to play Shaving a Haircut, 6 bits on the drums. I'd go, none of us at the time, youngsters, thought that that was anything profound. We're looking to be with Count Basie or Duke Ellington and hope to move up that way. But as I look back, that may have been the most profound musical experience of my life.
That experience was something Otis would later use to revolutionize music. In the meantime, big bands were the rage, and with Harlan Leonard's Kansas City Rockets and the great Lester Young, Otis made a name for himself. But what most listeners did not know was that Johnny Otis was white.
Your entrance into music was immediately and with musicians who played in the style that we think of as black music. You were playing with black musicians in a high school for this, and yet you're not black.
Why is
How did that come about?
Yes, I'm black, environmentally, culturally, and by choice. If you mean ethnically, my people are Greeks.
Otis' brand of jazz and rhythm and blues ignited the music world. He formed the Johnny Otis Show, an R&B caravan that featured his discoveries. He would always take a back seat to the singers he showcased, his stars. Today they are Charles Williams and Mary Coco Haynes.
When you get to that talking part, don't be self-conscious. Just think about the one you love, wherever they may be, and pretend that they're right here and do your thing.
Okay.
Amen?
All right.
Like here.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see, oh baby,
no I won't.
Williams and Haynes are the latest in a series of singers Otis discovered. Etta James, Linda Hopkins, Jackie Wilson, Little Esther, all got their starts with Johnny Otis. He thinks these two may be even bigger.
Stand by me.
In his own way, Otis has become a black Renaissance man. He's now Deputy Chief of Staff to Congressman Mervyn Dimley. He wanted more artistic expression, so he taught himself painting and sculpture and took first prize in a black art competition. However, despite all his accomplishments, Otis felt there was still a void in his life.
I was disillusioned with all facets of American life. So I became very cynical and I tried everything, every ism I could try. And I went all the way around Boyd, and one day I had to come back to Jesus. Because we're so vulnerable and so weak, and I couldn't find a better answer than forgiveness and love and brotherhood.
I said you can claim a victory against sickness with Jesus, against bad luck with Jesus,
yeah,
against heartache with Jesus,
yeah,
against jealousy with Jesus,
yeah,
against death, drugs, alcohol, impatience, impulsiveness, gambling, and selfishness. But you gotta have Jesus. I don't know if I'm right about it. I said, you gotta have Jesus.
when God gets through with me, I'll be what it wants me to be.
Johnny Otis has done it all. Husband and father, politician, artist, musician, and minister. But despite a recent album, Johnny Otis is now without a recording contract. So he prays, not only for love and brotherhood, but for someone, anyone, to offer a 61-year-old legend a chance to make more music.
One more time.